Hello students, again today we are going to discuss few more problems on SFD BMD, but here major stress will be given on overhanging beam. So today's topic is SFD and BMD for overhanging beams. Already in the theory part we have discussed what is overhanging beam. Overhanging means what? One end of the beam is cantilever like this. It is suspended over the support or it is extended over the support. Such a type of beam is called as overhanging beam. So here in the particular problem, part CD is overhanging part. Means it is not supported beyond the support. After C there is a no support at point D. This is called as overhang. So in this case only one end of the beam is overhang. That is CD part is overhang. Sometimes both the ends of the beams are overhanged. Such a type of problems are also available. Now we will discuss first problem. A overhanging beam 10 meter span, okay, 4 plus 4 plus 2, that is 10 meter, subjected to UDL 10 kilonewton per meter over a span of 4 meter from support E. From support A at a distance of 4 meter up to distance of 4 meter, there is a UDL of 10 kilonewton per meter. It also carries a point load of 20 kilonewton at point D. Draw SFD and BMD. Okay. Even though the part of the beam is overhanged, there is a no change in drawing SFD and BMD or the procedure of SFD and BMD. Only here this suspended part will cause a hogging bending moment like this. So this will bend like this. Normally between the support, EC is simply supported. So here this part will bend like this. So it is called as a sagging bending moment. Means bending in this particular portion will be positive, and then after that it will bend like this. CD part will bend like this. So this is called as a hogging bending moment. Whenever bending moment is hogging, that will be considered as a negative. Okay, so this is negative bending moment in the part CD. Okay, now initially we'll find support reactions. So using condition of equilibrium, first condition is summation of apex is zero. If you observe the problem, there is a no load in x direction. Okay, no load in x direction means what? Hinge is having two unknowns, ax and ay. Okay, but there is a no load in x direction, so ax must be equal to zero. Take second condition, summation of Fy equal to 0. Here Fy equal to 0 means what? Upward positive, downward negative. Upward Ay is positive, Cy is positive, 20 is downward, 10 into 4 is downward, and that will be minus. So I have written same thing here, plus Ay minus 10 into 4, that is UDL downward, minus 20 plus Cy equal to 0. Then you will get Ay plus Cy equal to 60, which is equation number 1. Now, take moment about A point. Take moment about this A point. If you take moment about A, moment of these two forces will be 0 about A. Then there will be moment of this UDL. You know that how moment of UDL is taken? 10 into 4, it is acting over 4 meter. 10 into 4 into half of UDL span means 2 meter. 10 into 4 into 2, that will be the moment about A, plus this 20, 20 into distance from A is 10 meter, because this UDL and this 20 both will rotate clockwise, like this clockwise, okay, this is clockwise rotation, 20 into 10, it is plus, but Cy will be minus, Cy is upward, so about A it will rotate anti-clockwise. So I have taken anti-clockwise negative, so minus Cy into 8, because distance from C is 8 meters equal to 0. By solving this you will get the value of Cy, and then put in equation 1 you will get Ay. So here you will get both the reactions, Ay as well as Cy. Once external reaction is obtained, now rest of the part is very simple to draw shear force and bending moment diagram. Okay, So this is free body diagram showing AY, CY. You know that AY is 25 and CY is 35. Okay. So what I did here, first of all, I have drawn SFD. You have to draw SFD. Okay. So to draw SFD, first of all, draw this horizontal line. Okay. Then start with point A. Okay. So 0, you just take calculator and try to add these values. First of all, take 0 in the calculator, then move by 25 upward, because here there is a reaction of 25, upward is positive. So how to find out shear force? 0 plus 25, then from A to B there is a UDL, okay? So plus 25 minus 10 into 4. Jitna bhi load hai A to B, wo 25 se minus karna hai. So plus 25 minus 10 into 4, 25 plus 40, 10 into 4, 40, 25 plus upward 25, downward minus, means plus 25 minus 40, so it will be minus 15. Then there is a no load from B to C, horizontal line. Then if you reach to point C, plus 35, means minus 15 plus 35, you will get plus 20. Then C to D, no load, horizontal line. At point D, plus 20, downward is minus 20, it will be 0. Okay? So in this way, you will get closed shear force diagram. The portion above the horizontal line will be positive shear force. Portion below horizontal line will be negative shear force. So this is shear force diagram. And now if you observe the shear force diagram, here we got one point, that is point P, where shear force changes sign, positive to negative. Where shear force changes sign, such a point is called as point of contrafacture. Okay, where bending moment is maximum. Where shear force is zero, bending moment is maximum. Means in this particular point, here bending moment will be maximum. Okay, 31.25. Now, from this diagram, SFD, you have to write down shear force calculation. Okay. Now start with this point. Wherever there are two values, one value is to the left, the second value is to the right. Wherever there is a single value, it will be shear force at point B. Okay. Now shear force at point A, to the left 0, to the right 25. Shear force at point B, only one value. So just write down shear force at B. What will be the shear force at B? Minus 15. Okay. It is minus 15. It is 25 minus 10 into 4. Shear force at C, you will get two values. To the left will be minus 15 and to the right will be 20. Okay. Shear force at D, again two values. One is plus 20, another is 0. Shear force to the left of D, 20. To the right of D, 0. So in this way, we will get the shear force calculation. And as there is a point of contrafacture, so you need to take similar triangle here by considering figure up to this particular point. Remove this particular part, show here and write down x upon this x upon 25 minus 4 minus x, because the distance is 4 meter. So remaining distance, if it is x, remaining is 4 minus x. So 4 minus x upon 15. So by solving this, you will get the distance of point of contrafacture from point E. And that distance we got 2.5 meters. So this is the point P. It is 2.5 meter from support A, where bending moment will be maximum. Okay. Now, after getting distance x, you have to find out bending moments. Okay. So, what are the important key points in the beam? Key points are supports A and D. Of course, at A and D, moment will be zero, because this point will be zero moments. Then there will be point of contrafacture P. Then there is a point B. Then there is a point C. Okay, C is also one of the point where here bending moment will not be zero, because this is the cantilever part. In cantilever, normally at the support moment is not zero. So bending moment at A and D is zero. Now you have to take bending moment at B. Where is B point? This one. If you take moment from this point, what are the forces here? 25 is the reaction. 25 will rotate clockwise. This UD will rotate anti-clockwise, because it is downward. Will rotate anti-clockwise about B, and this will rotate clockwise about B. So what will be moment about B? 25 25 into 4 meter up to B point. 25 into 4, that will be clockwise, so positive, minus 10 into 4 into 2, distance center of UDL from B, 2 meter. So minus 10 into 4 into 2. So we will get 20 kilonewton meter moment at B point. This is B point. So B point means what? Exactly under B point. You show this line and here moment is 20. Now you have to take moment about P point, at point of contrafacture, at this point. So this point is 2.5 meter from A. Okay. So take moment about point P. So total moment will be 25 into 2.5 up to point P. 25 into 2.5 clockwise positive, and this UDL will be anticlockwise. Its moment will be 25 into 2.5, this 25 into 2.5 clockwise positive, minus 10 into 2.5 into half of 2.5, half of UDL, up to point P and A, distance is 2.5, half of that 1.25. So total moment is 31.25 kilonewton meter. That is moment at point P. Okay, at point P, and show this moment here below, exactly below P. This moment is positive. Positive means above the line you have to draw. So we got two moments at B and at P. Same calculations are provided here, and these values are like this. Now another point is point C. Now we know that whenever there is a cantilever part or overhanging part, moment of that particular overhanging part is always negative. Now what will be the moment at point C? So at point C, moment will be this 20 into 2. Is 20 into 2. Even though it is rotating clockwise about C, but it is a cantilever part, that why you should consider this particular moment as a negative. So what will be that moment? 20 into 2 about point C will be 40, and that 40 will be minus. That's why I have plotted, because of cantilever it is negative, and I have plotted below this horizontal line. It shows negative. Okay. So we got moment at point C. Okay, after getting this moment, this point, now how to draw that? Observe the SFD. In SFD, it is the inclined line. Inclined line shows UDL. Okay, if it is single degree curve here in UDL, in BMD, it must be second degree curve, parabola. Means between portion A to B, this particular line will be curve, second degree curve. Okay. As this line is horizontal, means 0 degree curve, so here it must be first degree curve, inclined. SFD may horizontal hoga to, BMD may inclined line, 1 degree higher. Okay, so here it is 20-20 horizontal line, so it must be inclined line. Okay, if you joined all this, show minus here, plus here, or even you can hash this external portion of BMD. So this will be your bending moment diagram. Okay, so here you got SFD, you got BMD. But if you observe the BMD, in BMD also bending moment changes from plus to minus. Here you can see, this is plus bending moment, this is minus bending moment, positive, negative. Wherever there is a change in bending moment, sign change in bending moment, it is also called as a point of contrafacture in bending moment. Okay, point of contrafacture in bending moment. To find out that particular distance, you can use similar triangle. Okay. So here it, this line is a straight line, that's why you need to take similar triangle. If this is suppose curve, at that time similar triangle is not applicable. Whenever there is a curve, at that time you should take moment about this point N equal to 0. Okay, consider moment of from any support. If you take moment from this point up to N and equate it to 0, why 0? Because moment at N is 0, you will get the distance x. In that case, whenever there is a UDL and moment is 0, if you are taking moment at N point, what will be the moment? 25 into distance up to N point. Okay, so here up to B point, we know that it is 4 meter, but this distance is x. You have to assume this as a x. Means 25 into 4 plus x minus 10 into this total distance is 4 meter. Okay. 4 meter, 10 into 4 into. Now this distance from UDL will be 4, half of 4 is 2 plus is x. this will be x plus half of 2, 2 plus x equal to 0. Okay, sometimes you may get quadratic equation. So you can solve quadratic equation and find out the value of x. Okay, so in this way you can locate the point of contrafacture in bending moment diagram also. Now in SFD also there is one point of contrafacture. In BMD also there is one point of contrafacture. Okay, so these are the typical cases. Very rarely this will happen. Now we'll discuss about next problem. Now this is problem number 2. It is just similar one, just like previous problem, but instead of one problem, one point load, here in this problem UDL was there and one point load was there. Now here there are two point loads. UDL is there 1 kN per meter and there are two point loads of 2 kN each. Okay, again A and B are two supports and 5 m is the overhanging part. In the similar fashion, just like previous problem, you solve this problem. Find, take fx0, take fy0, you will get ra plus rb minus 10 into 10 minus 2 minus 2. That will be equation 1. Ra plus rb equal to 14, because ra rb upward and load is 2 plus 2 plus 10 into 1, 10 means 10 plus 4, 14. Okay, and then take moment about a, 1 into 10 into 5. Okay, clockwise, but this one is clockwise, so positive. So 1 into 10 into 5 plus 2 into 15 plus this 2 into 20 minus this RB into 15, anti-clockwise. Loads are rotating clockwise and RB rotating anti-clockwise. So here you will get support reactions. So RB is equal to 8 kN, then RA will be 6 because total should be 14. Okay, so here we got support reactions. Now from support reactions, you just put that value here, RA is 8, RB is 6. Draw horizontal line here, horizontal line, and now show the shear force. So plus 8, move by 8 upward direction, 0 to 8. You take values in the calculator, 0, then plus 8, minus 1 into 10. From A to E, when you will proceed, at that time, plus 8 minus 1 into 10. Okay, so plus 8 minus 10, it will be minus 2. So this value will be minus 2, means below line. From E to D, no load, horizontal line. Okay, so it is minus 2, minus 2, again downward minus. This is already a minus 2. Again, there is a point load in downward direction. So minus 2, minus 2, it will be minus 4. No load from D to B. Okay, horizontal line. At B point, there is a 6 kN reaction. This is minus 4 plus 6, you will get plus 2. It will be above the line. Then no load from B to C, horizontal line. Okay, so plus 2, and here there is a downward reaction, plus 2, this downward will be minus 2, you will get 0. So in this way, we will get SFD. The same values I have written here. To the left, 0, to the right, 8. Okay, at E point, minus 2. Okay, here at E point shear force is minus 2, at D point to the left minus 2, to the right minus 4, at B point to the left minus 4, to the right 2, at C point to the left minus plus 2, to the right 0, in this way. So this is the shear force calculation, and if you observe the diagram, in this particular portion there is a change in sign convention of shear force. It is a negative. Here it is positive, so it is a point of contrafacture. So consider part from this dotted line. Yahan se left side itna consider karo. Take similar triangle, find out the distance x, the fair bending moment will be maximum. Now you have to draw bending moment diagram. So we have just calculated location of point of contrafacture, that is here. Okay, so that will be maximum under point P. So take moment about P point first, moment about E first. E point means what? This point. Okay, so moment about E kya hoga? 8 into 10. Okay, this is clockwise, 8 into 10 minus 1 into 10 into 5. That will be the 30 kN meter. So 10 into 8 80 80 minus this 50 30 kilonewton meter. Okay, means at E point moment is 30, so this point is 30. So moment at P point, take moment about P point. P is at distance of 8 meters. Here we have calculated distance of point P. So point P is at a distance of 8 meter from support E. So take moment about P point. Here 8 into 8, this support, 8 into this 8 minus 1 into 8 into 4. So we'll get 32 kilonewton meter, that is moment at P point. Now moment at D point also you can calculate, that is 20. Moment at D also you can calculate. So this is moment at D, this. It is B. Mistakenly here I have written B, but this point must be moment at D point. So D point is this one, 8 into 15 minus 1 into 10 into 5 plus 5. What is this 5 plus 5? We are taking moment about D point. Now this will be this 5 plus this center from UDL, that is 5. That is 5 plus 5. That is moment under D will be 20 kilonewton meter. And then moment about B. B means what? This point. This B point is a BC is a cantilever. So that moment is 2 into 5. 2 into 5 and that will be negative because due to cantilever. Okay. So 2 into minus 5. 2 into 5 minus 10, that moment will be minus 10. So this minus because of overhanging. Here it is negative and then just joined it by the lines observing SFD. In SFD it is horizontal, so here it must be inclined. Horizontal jahan pe hoga uske niche inclined line. And whenever there is an inclined line below that there must be second degree curve. So this is first degree line, so it must be second degree line. Means up to this point 2. So this portion, up to this portion, this diagram must be parabolic variation, second degree curve, and now everywhere rest of the part it will be straight line. So this is about problem number 2. Now see problem number 3. What I did here, I have intentionally taken this problem because here both the ends of the beams are overhanged. Both the ends of the beams are overhanged. Okay. When both the ends of the beams are overhanged, at that particular point, moment will be negative in overhanging portion. Here in this 0.6 portion, 0.7 portion, moment will be negative. Okay, here simply supported between this point and this point. So here there will be sagging moment, bending moment, and at this part there will be hogging bending moment, because bending will be like this. In both the cases, bending is downward, hogging here it will be sagging between the support. Now, just use condition of equilibrium, Fx0, no load in x direction, that's why I have not considered that condition. Fy0 means what? Plus Rb, plus Rf, minus 1, minus 5 into 0.7, minus 4, minus 2, you will get equation 1. Now, you take moment about any end, either at A, okay, either at G, okay, or you want to make one of the support 0, you can take moment about B or you can take moment about F point, so that RB, RF will be 0. And after solving this, you will get support reaction RB and RE. After getting support reaction, next job is to draw shear force diagram. Now, first of all, you draw horizontal line like this. To draw shear force diagram, our reactions are plus 3.7 plus 6.8, both are upward. So starting with, this is zero magnitude line, this dark line horizontal. Now to draw SFD, start with this point, end point. This is horizontal line. Now this, you can see this load is not upward now, it is downward. So zero downward minus one. Okay. Zero, it is downward, so minus one. No load from A to B, horizontal line. Come to at B point, there is a plus 3.7 reaction. So minus 1 plus 3.7, minus 1 plus 3.7, it will be plus 2.7. Then no load in this portion, horizontal line. Then there is a UDL, so plus 2.7 minus 5 into 0.7, you will reach to minus 0.8. No load in DE, so horizontal line. Then minus 0.8, minus 4, it will be 4.8. No load from E to F horizontal line. Then RF is 6.8. Okay. So minus 4.8 plus 6.8, you will get plus 2. Then no load from F to G, it is plus 2. Downward minus 2, it will be 0. Okay. And from the shear force diagram, you write down shear force calculation. Wherever there are two values, you write down first value as a left, second value as a right. Okay. Now in this case, first value is 0 to the left, second is minus 1. First to the left at B, minus 1, to the right, plus 2.7. To the left, here at point C, only one value, so shear force at C is plus 2.7. Wherever there are two values, you should write down left, right, like this. And then you have to draw bending moment diagram. Okay. So here you can see this bending moment is negative. 2 into 0.6, 1.2. It is negative because this part is overhang. Similarly, 1 into 0.7, it is 0.7. That is also below this line, so minus 0.7. And then you take moment under this particular points, moment at C, moment at D, moment at E. Okay. So in the similar fashion, I have shown all the calculation below. Okay. So try to solve this or try to calculate value your own. Okay. And complete this particular problem. So in this way, whenever there are overhanging beam, you can draw SFD and BMD. Now you go through any book of strength of material and try to solve similar type of problems. Okay. Now here I have given one problem, just similar to previous third problem. Draw SFD and BMD for this particular beam, which is loaded as shown in figure. If you observe the problem here, 1 meter, 1 meter, 1.3, 1.3, it is 70, 20, 20. Means it is symmetrically loaded beam. So reactions will be directly half half. RC and RE will be same. RC equal to RE equal to addition of this 20 plus 70, 90 plus 20, 110. Means RC and RE will be 110 by 2. So 110 by 2 means what? 55, 55. So both the reactions are 55, 55. After getting the reactions, your problem is solved. So intentionally, I have shown here solution also. So that whenever you will solve your own, you will find that whether your values are correct or wrong. So in this way, solve the problem of SFD and BMD by considering different type of overhanging beams. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.